Welcome to the session Minimization Techniques using KMap. At the end of this session, students will be able to describe different logical functions on KMap and also solve different logical functions using KMap. So these are the contents of video lecture. Simplification of logical functions makes digital circuits simpler and faster. But simplification of logical functions using Boolean algebra laws and rules is time consuming and error prone. So to overcome above problem, in 1953, Maurice Kernoff, an engineer at Bell Laboratories, invented a graphical way of visualizing and then simplifying logical functions. Therefore, this graphical representation of logical functions, now known as Kernoff map or simply KMap. KMap is a matrix consisting of rows and columns which forms squares known as cells. Each square or cell represents the output values of a logical function. The output values placed in each cell are derived from the min terms or max terms of a logical function. All the cells of KMap are arranged in a gray code sequence where only one bit changes at a time. Kernoff maps or KMaps are mostly used to simplify logical problems with 2, 3 or 4 variables. Now let us see KMap for 2 variables. For 2 input variables, a KMap consists of 2^2 cells, that is 4 cells as shown in below diagram. So to know how many cells are there, for that we have formula cell is equal to 2^n, where n is the number of variables. So you can see this is the structure for 2 input variable where we have considered A and B are 2 variables where A may have value 0 or 1 and B also having value 0 or 1. So you can see the structure here where the cell represents 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1 where these are cell number 0, 1, 2 and 3. Now the next KMap will show you mean terms for each cell. So here is A bar B bar, A bar B, A B bar, A B. And for max term, you can see here A plus B bar, A bar plus B, A bar plus B bar. So this is how mean term and max term can be represented using two variable KMap. For three input variable, the KMap having 2^3 8 cells as shown in below diagram. So here A, variable A is taken at a row side and B and C are taken at column side. So A may having value 0 or 1 and B and C having value 0, 0, 0, 1, then 1, 1 and 1, 0 because here we are following gray code. So total 8 cells are there. For 4 input variables, a KMap consists of 2^4 is equal to 16 cells as shown in below diagram. So for 4 variable, 2 variables are taken at row side and 2 variable CD are taken at column side. Only standard or canonical form of logical function can be represented on KMap. So for example, here is the function f1 of ABC equal to A bar B bar C bar plus A B C bar plus A bar B C bar, which is a standard SOP. A standard SOP is a SOP where in all the terms, all the variables are present. If it is not, then it is not a standard or a canonical. Now let us have a next equation, function 2 of ABC equal to A plus B plus C into A plus B bar plus C bar into A bar plus B plus C bar. This is what a standard POS, where again in all these terms, all the variables are present. So this is a standard POS or canonical POS, product of sum. Now let us see how to represent a standard SOP on a KMap. A logical function in a standard SOP form can be represented on KMap by just entering once in the cells of KMap corresponding to each mean term in the equation. Now let us have one example. F1 ABC is equal to A bar B bar C bar, which represents 0, A B C bar which represents 4 plus A bar B C bar which represents 2. So in soft form, this equation can be written as summation m 0 to 4. So to represent this equation on k-map, we require three input variable k-map, as we have three variables here. And just by entering once into respective cell 0, 2, 4, you can represent SOP equation. Now let us see how to represent a standard POS on k-map. A logical function in a standard POS form can be represented on k-map by just entering zeros in the cells of k-map corresponding to each max term in the equation. So here is the example, f2 of abc equal to a plus b plus c into a plus b bar plus c bar plus into a bar plus b bar plus c, which is a standard POS and can be represented in a max term as pi capital M 036. So we have to enter zeros into cell number 036. So this is how we can represent a POS on k-map. Now let us see how to simplify a logical function using k-map. The simplification is based on the principle of combining terms, that is mean terms or max terms, in adjacent cells. Two or more cells are called adjacent cells if they differ in only one variable. So let us see how to make a pair which is nothing but two adjacent cells. So by making a pair, one variable can be eliminated. For example, here we have two input variable k-map, where 1,1 is present in cell number 1, 2, 3. So here we can make a pair of cell number 1 and 3, because here only variable A is changing its value 0 to 1, but B is constant throughout this column. And the next pair can be made by making a cell number 2, 3 a pair. So here variable A is remaining same throughout cell number 2 and 3, but B is changing its value. So in k-map, the variable whose value is changed is cancelled. So by making this pair, variable B is get cancelled, so only A remains whose value is 1. So in this equation, Y is equal to A and B. So for this pair, B remains same having value 1, but A changes its value, so A is cancelled. So in this way, a variable is get cancelled whose value is changed. Now let us see how to make a quad, which means by making a group of four adjacent ones. By making a quad, two variable can be eliminated. Different ways of making a group of four adjacent ones, that is quad, are as below. So first group is making a horizontal ones. So here you can see it is a four input k-map, where you can see all ones are present in a row. So this is a picture as horizontal ones. So you can make up a group of four adjacent ones, then you can eliminate two variables. So here by solving this, you can get a bar b. So as a is having value 0 and b is having value 1, so this will give you a bar b. Now next is vertical ones. So when all ones are present in a column, it seems as a vertical. So in this way, you can eliminate two variable. All A and B's are get cancelled, only C and D having the same values throughout the all these cells. So C is having 1 and D is having value 1. So this equation gives you CD. Now let us see forming a square. So you can form square like this. So that will give you A bar C. One of the form is leftmost and rightmost ones. So here you can see leftmost and rightmost ones are made in a group called as a quad, and it will give you BD bar. Then this is the picture where you can make a group of upper one and lower one, making a quad. So here it is get reduced to B bar C. And one more grouping is done where all corner ones are present. So here it gives you B bar D bar. Now let us see how to make octet, which means making a group of eight adjacent ones. So by making an octet, three variable can be eliminated. Different ways of making group of 8 adjacent ones are horizontal ones. So again here, if all the ones are present in 8 adjacent ones, so you can make a group of horizontal ones. So it will give you one variable by eliminating three variables. So here you can see A is changing its value and all C and D's are changing value, but only B is having same value 1, 1. So this gives you B. By making group of four vertical ones gives you D. Now let us see how to make a group where leftmost and rightmost ones are present. So in this way you can make octet and it gives you D bar. Now one of the method where all ones are present at uppermost and lowermost, so it can form a octet. So in this example it gives you B bar. Now let us have one example where we have a function f of w, x, y, z and these are cell numbers. By putting ones into these cells, as this equation is a SOP, we can make an octet and two pair. So octet will eliminate three variables, so only one variable is present, and pair will eliminate only one variable. So there are three variables each in these terms. So always you have to form a bigger group, that is you have to give the priority to the octet, then to the quad and then to the pair, because octet eliminate three variables, then quad eliminates two variables and pair eliminates only one variable.